Hello everyone, today we will discuss Finkelstein reaction. It is the reaction of halogens. So this is the reaction of alkyl halide. R is alkyl group, X can be chlorine or bromine. So it is the reaction of alkyl chlorides or alkyl bromides with sodium iodide or potassium iodide. And here one organic solvent is used, that is acetone CH3CO CH3, and means propanol or acetone. Actually this is a polar aprotic solvent. This is a polar aprotic solvent. Actually this reaction follows SN2 mechanism, that's why we require polar aprotic solvent. It will not form any hydrogen bond. So the reaction is SN2 nucleophilic substitution reaction, but a second order reaction. So this is actually halogen exchange method. This X is replaced by this iodine. I here is a nucleophile, and this X is a leaving group. So this nucleophile will displace this leaving group. As a result, alkyl iodide is formed and sodium halide is precipitated out. For example, we use methyl chloride reacts with sodium iodide in presence of acetone. So we will get methyl iodide and sodium chloride. It will form a precipitate. Actually sodium iodide is soluble in acetone, but sodium chloride or sodium bromide, they are insoluble in acetone, so they will precipitate and they are removed. Actually initially this reaction is in equilibrium, dynamic equilibrium is there. To make the reaction shift in forward reaction, this byproduct must be removed, and this is insoluble in acetone, so it will form precipitate and separated out. So reaction will shift in forward reaction. That's why acetone is used as a solvent, and we take halide as a chloride and a bromide. They are insoluble in solvent, in acetone. So this is the Finkelstein reaction, or we can say this is a halogen exchange method. This is a halogen exchange method. One halide is replaced by another halide. This reaction follows the SN2 mechanism, so there will be inversion configuration. How inversion configuration will take place? Now let us understand that. For example, we have a methyl chloride. The bond of carbon and chlorine is shown by a dotted line. It means this chloride is away from observer. This chloride is away from observer. So when it reacts with sodium iodide, here I is nucleophile. The reaction follows SN2 mechanism. In SN2 mechanism, inversion of configuration takes place. So this nucleophile will attack from this side, from the front direction, or we can say opposite direction of this leaving group. As a result, we will obtain alkyl iodide. Now the bond of carbon and iodine is shown by wedge, means this iodine is now towards the observer. Initially the chloride is away from the observer, but after the reaction alkyl iodide is formed and the bond of carbon and iodine is shown by wedge line. It means it is towards the observer. So there is inversion configuration take place. So this is inversion of configuration. That is the important of a Finkelstein reaction. The reaction is quite simple and it is suitable to form a alkyl iodides, right? So that's it for a Finkelstein reaction. I hope you would understand it. Thanks for watching.